Tom, well, I have to start out with tonight because I'm out here right now and it's very cold. So if you plan on coming out here tonight, make sure that you bundle up. There's lots of fun stuff. They're starting to distribute some of the ice statues, and they're also going to be doing the fire and ice show where they cut a bunch of ice and then light it on fire. It'll be really cool. But tomorrow, this is what the forecast looks like. In the morning, we'll be in the low 30s, so the ice should stay melted pretty well. By the afternoon, we're warming into the upper 30s, so I'm going to be a little bit worried about some of these ice statues starting to melt, but it will be good for everybody out here enjoying the festivities. And by the evening hours, that's when we will start seeing temperatures back down into the low 30s, and we'll have a good chance for the sculptures to stay nice and cold and frozen. But right now, take a look around. We've got lots of people starting to make their way to the festival. They're taking out a life-size Darth Vader right there. They're going to move that out pretty soon. They just took it out of the truck. I'm told that they're keeping a lot of the sculptures in the truck at this point so that they're nice and fresh for tomorrow morning. But this one, they are taken out right now. Now tomorrow, they're going to be carving sculptures live starting at 9 a.m. to 4. There will be family activities, an ice cream booth, and there are all day interactive activities. So take a look at this right here. This is a set of cornhole that's made out of ice. We've also got a ping pong table made with ice and Planko. It's going to be so fun. So make sure you head out here. Tomorrow's the day. Sunday, it's going to be a little less likely because we'll start to see a lot more melting and that rain. So reporting live now in Niles, I'm First Warning Neighborhood Meteorologist Erica Horvatine.